Hey there folks, it's Matthew Seville here with SLRLounge.com. Recently we went to Joshua Tree National Park to do a bunch of gear reviews, and of course the focus of our trip was the new Sigma 18-35mm f1.8 zoom. It's the first f1.8 zoom ever made. And the reason that we chose Joshua Tree was of course because of the Perseid meteor shower that was occurring at the time. It's a beautiful annual event if you've never seen it before, and there's nothing like the desert to photograph a meteor shower. It's just a beautiful place with the Joshua trees and the rocks, and the sunsets and sunrises are just amazing. But it's hard to pick a composition, so we drove around the park, you know, it's the sun setting, it's dusk, we're driving around the park looking for a place to shoot, and what I decided was I wanted a composition that included the campgrounds in it so that you could see a little bit of human interaction. And this is what we came up with. Now what you're seeing here is about an hour or an hour and a half's worth of time lapse, and you can't really even see the meteor shower, but you can see some airplanes going through the sky, but all you see is the stars rotating. The northern stars up there in the upper right. This is what it looks like when you combine all of the meteor showers from all of that time into one photograph. We wound up with over a dozen meteors in that one single composition with the Sigma 18. This is at 18 millimeters, f1.8, by the way. Let me show you a little bit of what this lens is delivering in terms of image quality. I'm going to zoom in here. This is at 18 millimeters and at wide open at f1.8. And the sharpness is just outstanding from this lens. Even up here in the corners, if you're into astrophotography, you can see there's very little coma. And down here, you know, I'm at ISO 3200, but there's just amazing sharpness going on. I have a few other images, let me show you. I did a self-portrait under the Milky Way once the Milky Way rotated through the sky a little bit. And as the sun was coming up, I shot a few more photos. And overall, again, I mean, let me get out of here. I'm shooting this landscape photo at f2.5, which you really shouldn't do for landscapes, but right up to the edges, it is just amazingly sharp right up here. Overall, it does have a little bit of chromatic aberration in the extreme corners and at harsh, harsh edges, but chromatic aberration is something that I just really never worry about because Lightroom is so dang good at correcting it these days. And there's a few other images here I wanted to show you, some panoramas, some macro close-ups. Overall, I just had a great time shooting with this lens. However, if you were to ask me, what is this lens made for? I would actually answer, with the equivalent of 28 to 50 or so millimeters, it's not really meant to be a wide angle zoom for landscapes. It's really more meant to be, let me click over here, I've got a few other images. It's really meant to be, you know, for general photojournalism and stuff like that. These images really showcase what I felt like was really enjoyable time shooting with this lens. There's a few images I can show you. Again, the sharpness is just amazing. I could go right to the very edge of this image and it's just got great detail. And the background blur, the bokeh, is actually quite pretty. Let me hit N here again and show you. This is what the lens looks like at 18. This is what it looks like at 35 millimeters. And the depth of field is really quite pretty. Let me zoom in here and show you what it looks like. This is what I would consider busy bokeh, and it looks quite nice. All in all, I'm really bummed out to have to send this lens back. I wish I could keep it. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what other lenses Sigma has up their sleeves in this fast aperture, wide angle, or fast aperture zoom department. Because really, if I had to sum up what this lens does, I would say it is a replacement to three professional grade prime lenses all rolled into one, which is a truly amazing accomplishment. So bravo to Sigma for this lens. Anyways, folks, thank you so much for tuning in and take care.